Whether you want an icebreaker for your webinar or need to quiz your meeting attendees, polling for Zoom meetings and webinars is a valuable tool. In this video, we will learn how to create and launch polls, manage quizzes, and create poll and quiz libraries. Hosts can create polls before or during a webinar or meeting, with a maximum of 10 questions per poll and 50 polls per webinar or meeting. If you do not see features shown in the video, your administrator has not enabled them, or polling is not included in your current account plan. To create a poll before a webinar, navigate to zoom.us, locate webinars from the navigation on the left, then find the polls/quizzes tab. This is your poll library, a collection of polls you can enable for all future webinars. Any polls created here will remain in your library. Polls created in the library will appear in all future webinars if enabled. Although polling looks and functions the same for webinars and meetings, the libraries are separate. Polls you save in your webinar library will not appear in your meetings poll library. Click Create and select Poll. Here, you can customize the name of your poll, decide between single or multiple choice, and create your question and answer choices. You can add up to 10 answer choices. Delete or duplicate the question by clicking the icons in the bottom right corner of the box. Click Add Question to create additional questions. Once you have created all the questions for your poll, click Save. The poll is now a part of your poll library. Disabling polls will hide them in future webinars. Click the Upcoming tab and select Schedule a Webinar. Edit your webinar settings and click Schedule. Next, click the Polls/Quizzes tab. Polls that you previously enabled will appear. Click Create to add additional polls. Click Library, then enable or disable polls from your library before the webinar begins. Once you start the webinar, locate the toolbar and click Polls/Quizzes. Enabled polls will appear. Here, you can launch, duplicate, or make edits. Don't need it? Just delete it. It's never too late to add a poll to your webinar. Click the plus sign to create a new poll. This time, let's select Advanced Polls and Quizzing. To reuse this poll for a later webinar, check the box Add to Polls/Quizzes Library. Customize the name of your poll. Select the question type. With advanced polling and quizzing, you have multiple options. While matching is a great way to quiz on multiple vocabulary words, short or long answers are great options when asking open-answered questions. Use the rating scale to see attendees' opinions on how the webinar is going. Try quizzing your audience on what they've learned. After creating a question, click the More dropdown, then check the box for Make it a Quiz, and set correct answers. For each question, click Set Answer, select a correct answer, and click Done. Question types such as short answer, long answer, and rating scale will not allow you to set a correct answer. Additionally, require answers to be anonymous. With this option, the poll report will only show the response, not who gave it. While only the host can create and edit polls, both hosts and co-hosts can launch them. Once launched, you will see the results in real time, along with a timer to show how long the poll has been live and how many attendees have answered. After ending the poll, you can share the results with attendees. For quizzes, you can check the box for Show Correct Answers to All if you want attendees to see what they answered right or wrong. Stop sharing and click the kebab menu to relaunch the poll, which will erase previous answers. Download results, which will export a CSV of all poll results, or view the results from a browser. Well, that's it for now. Happy polling!